9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we have liftoff of TDRS-M on the Atlas V rocket from Space Launch Complex 41. TDRS-M, securing space-to-ground communication for NASA's low Earth orbit operations, including the International Space Station.
Atlas beginning. Should yaw maneuver and steer to its planned path at inclination of 26.2 degrees.
RC engine pressure.
You're hearing the voice of Patrick Moore providing launch vehicle ascent data. Patrick is the United Launch Alliance Denver Network Operations Center Command Control Center.
Pump speeds and injector pressures all looking good.
Now reading the data coming directly from the rocket.
The Atlas rocket carrying TDRS-M reached supersonic speed at 1 minute and 20 seconds into flight.
Now passing 1 minute into flight. Vehicle is now 3 miles in altitude and traveling at 1,100 miles per hour.
Standing by for max Q or
now passing
1
minute 15 seconds into flight.
32 seconds into flight.
Mach 1, Atlas 5 is now supersonic. One minute, 30 seconds into flight. Now passing through max Q, maximum dynamic pressure.
This is the point when mechanical stress on the rocket reaches its peak because of the rocket's velocity and resistance created by the atmosphere.
The RD-180 is throttled down to 95% thrust as expected. Engine response looks good. This engine thrust profile will continue until the vehicle reaches a program 5G acceleration limit.
About 2 minutes into the flight
and
of Atlas.
And now passing 2 minutes into flight, approximately 2 minutes remaining in the first stage of flight. Vehicle trajectory traveling right down the middle of the range track, looking good. RD-180 engine operating parameters also looking good.
Booster engine cutoff slated for 4 minutes, 2 seconds after launch.
The Atlas V rocket now weighs just one half of what it did at launch, burning propellant at a rate of almost 2,600 pounds per second. And vehicle has gone to closed loop guidance. Now passing 2 minutes, 30 seconds into flight.